Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to talk about how to edit a model or dataset in Power BI services. What's new in this? Actually, till now, before recording this video, or I think until June 2023, we don't have an option to edit a dataset in Power BI services. What it means? When you develop a model in Power BI desktop, once you publish it, in order to create any new measure or calculated column, or in order to create any relationship, you need to come to Power BI desktop and republish the dataset. That is the major drawback of Power BI. And with this feature, you have ability to overcome that limitation. You can edit a model and dataset in Power BI services. How to do it? Let's try to check it out as part of this video. So in order to do it, you need to enable it in the workspace level. And once you do it, you need to ensure that these changes are permanent. And it can able to validate the relationship that is part of July 2023 release, once you create a relationship. And it also comes with various limitations that I'm going to show it to you as well. So let's go into Power BI service and let's check it out how we can edit our what is I'm talking about in this video. This channel contains a free content and you can utilize this, and this covers MS BI, Power BI, SQL and basics of Azure as well. Share with your friends and colleagues whoever want to learn Power BI and anything related to data analytics. Let's begin. So I'm in Power BI service now and I have a data set here, and this is the report I created on top of it. So once you can see here, there is no option to edit, but you have something like open data model, which is grayed out. How to enable it? So basically go to this workspace settings, click on the settings. There comes Power BI and general, and you have options here. Allow workspace members to edit data models in the service. So ensure this, you are at least having a member or admin role so that you can able to edit this data sets. And edits are permanent and automatically saved in this future preview, and version history isn't saved. So maybe in future Power BI will come up with the version histories so that you can revert back something is going wrong. This setting does not apply to direct like dataset editing datasets through API or XML endpoint. So these are some of the limitations they predominantly highlighted. There are a lot more limitations that I will highlight at the end of the video. So let's begin now. We have enabled this option. Let's go back to our dataset here. Now the grayed out is removed and it is available for us to edit. Once you click on it, you can see the relationship, the modeling tab automatically pops up here. So let's try to, and you can see they are keep on warning, keep in mind your changes are permanent and automatically saved. So basically the modeling feature comes with creating a new measure, new column and new table, and you can create reports as well. And more importantly, you can also add the RLS as well. So these are the 4 to 5 items you can do with this edit in Power BI services mode. So I hope I don't want to repeat the steps, what you can do, what else you can't do, because everyone, most of them who are watching this video, they are aware what I'm talking about. The modeling means creating a measure. If you don't aware, just follow my complete playlist, you will understand it. So this is what I want to highlight for now. And moreover, like what I want to highlight in this is like this comes with a lot of limitations as well, where you can see here there is still many functional gaps between the model view and desktop and services. As I said, the model view in the desktop is far more better, as a lot of options compared to the services. So first limitation we will consider, like data sets that have incremental refresh, data sets have deployed pipeline, data sets modified by XML endpoint. These things you cannot able to edit like normal edition. So this feature will work when you have a simple data set and your organization is a very mid-level organization and you don't have a huge data sets that involves these functionalities. Then if you want to have a demo, you identified there is something wrong with this particular data set and you want to add a quick measures, that no need to depend on developer to deploy it. You can just edit it and fix that code so that it will works. Please ensure that, because whatever you have in your local version, once you publish it, these changes will be overwritten. This is the some developer disadvantages, how you need to maintain it. So having said that, you can go through all these limitations by yourself, because a lot of things mentioned here. So this is what I want to highlight. One more last thing about this feature is, like, till now Mac is not supported. You cannot have a Power BI in the Mac PCs. So this will overcome this limitation. Once you have published your Power BI file, and those who are using a Mac system, they can able to edit in the desktop since it's browser based. So this is one of the feature I want to highlight. I hope that's it. So if you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries, and do remember that data is your asset.